everybody, welcome back to Let's Play FTL. Last episode was the most heartbreaking loss we have had yet. I know we've been playing as the Zoltan Cruiser a lot and making some good progress with it. I am going to go back to the Kestrel, though, and we're going to call this Noah. Why not? It's kind of like humanity's arc, right? To ensure that the Federation survives. And let's just at least try to get, like, the second layout, which I hear is pretty good. What do we need? Have 6 unique aliens on the Kestrel Cruiser simultaneously. We can make that happen. Theoretically, it's a little luck-based. Have 8 systems and 3 subsystems. And repair back to full health when it only has 1 HP remaining. That seems a little unlikely, but this is fine. We actually have, I'm just going to assume this is Bear Taffy. This is Carrie Bryan's brother from Mythbusters. And this is Wilson Phillips. They're going to sing Hold On for us. It's going to be nice. We're going to play on easy difficulty. Why? I want to unlock more layouts, but in order to unlock more layouts, I actually have to do well. And to do well, I basically have to play on easy. And if you're not finding this tense on easy, I apologize, basically. But this is what has to be done, I feel, for right now. I went for the giant alien spider one, and I took the more aggressive option. Ended up getting 6 fuel, 6 missiles, and 14 scrap as a result, which is very, very nice. We don't even need to keep Artemis powered up for now, so how do we want to handle this? Well, why don't we get 20 and 15? Why don't we get one more bar of engine power right now just to increase our dodge chance? We really have to get our dodge chance high on the Kestrel because we don't have any energy shield that can protect us from missiles. So that's going to be very, very important. What else is important? Getting another weapon in addition to the Burst Laser Mark II would be nice. I mean, we have a missile launcher in the form of the Artemis, but I'd rather not use those missiles until it's absolutely 100% necessary. But I do want to get involved in as much combat as possible. You arrive at a populated sector. One merchant seems to be mass broadcasting a request for a mercenary ship to aid him. We will help. Your ship seems reasonably equipped. A freighter carrying a shipment of my goods is a week late. Fools flew through a pirate-filled sector in their haste, and I fear for their cargo's safety. I'm looking for a less incompetent captain to investigate. Captain? Is that seriously what just came out of my mouth? But yeah, we'll do it. I think we might be able to get to the exit. You know what? We might just say screw that quest. It probably has good rewards, but man, that beacon was really far away. I'm actually going to fight this ship. And, oh, they hacked us right away, please. Okay, they didn't hack our weapons, at least. By the way, so many people let me know, and I actually do appreciate it, but so many people let me know that on that Rebel flagship fight that took me like half an hour in the last episode, I definitely should have just... Where'd the bomb go? It missed. Okay. I definitely should have just jumped away and then come back and hoped that they had not hacked our weapons again. That's a very smart tactic. It's very unfortunate that I had to go through what I went through to learn it. But now I know it, and hopefully I won't mess that up so much in the future. So thank you for giving me that tip. It's a useful one, don't get me wrong. Let's make sure to save our layout of where our crew members are right now. And I'm kind of getting used to the Kestrel again. I know it's regarded as a pretty shitty ship. That's okay. I'm a pretty shitty player, so maybe we're a good match. So, first is done here. First fight. Gives us a little bit of extra scrap. What's the first thing you get on the Kestrel? Probably second level doors, just to future-proof you a little bit for anybody that might board. And then a second level of shield seems like a pretty smart idea considering... yeah, we're definitely going to attack the ship. Second level of shield seems very useful considering we're not actually going to be able to absorb anything on our energy shield. So dodge, block, doors, I think, is in reverse order. That's how we're going to handle it. Dodge, block, doors. Yeah, okay, it would be in reverse order. And I really love having the Burst Laser, but another thing that I would love to do is pick up one of the new weapons in the game. Artemis and Burst Laser is pretty old hat, but that's okay because, you know, people that are watching this will know how they would react in the same situation. In fact, many of you, most of you maybe even, I'm assuming, have more ships unlocked than me. I unfortunately do not have very many, but we can get the Lanius Cruiser at least. I really want to get Type B. Oh, what did we get? Oh, we got a second laser. There you go. I really want to get Type B of this ship, because I hear it's actually pretty good. I think it's called the Red Tail. So we need to get as many aliens on our ship as possible, and as many systems. Luckily, we're on easy, so we can buy a lot of that stuff. So, let me see. Hull Laser. Hull Smasher Laser Mark II. Fires 3 shots per charge. Only takes a little bit longer than the Burst Laser to charge. Requires 3 power, though, which is a ton. But, if we get that... Let me look at this for a second. Right now, we would need 2 more power in weapons to do that. I think we should prioritize it. I really feel like prioritizing weapon power is the most important thing if you get a weapon early, because then you take less damage over time and can get more scrap over time, I think. Let me look at my ship again quickly for a second. Burst Laser Mark II shoots 3 shots in 12 seconds with 1 damage. This does 2 damage on systemless rooms, but it also has a good chance to do a breach. So we are gonna just get one more weapon power. What I was thinking is maybe we could just, you know, keep Artemis and Burst Laser powered up, but I don't think that's the right way to handle it. I think it's smart to rush that next level of weapon power and then keep both lasers going at the same time, and then that really reduces the amount we're gonna have to use Artemis in the near future. Something red looms, it's the Mantis. You know, I know the game does its best at trying to make the Mantis feel like this really dangerous threat, but I don't really find them that bad. When they board, it's just basically a puzzle game. Here's the beam. This could be an issue. Oh, we hit it. Okay, that was really, really lucky. Yeah, I usually don't find the Mantis to be that big of an issue. If I had to pick, like, a ship that I like the least, I don't know. I don't really mind which aliens I end up fighting, to be honest with you. Most of the time, it doesn't really seem to make a huge difference. Oh, please tell me we can get our laser shot off before they can fire the beam and laser combo. It looks like we'll probably be fine here. They'll get one shot off. Oh, they just wasted their beam. Okay, even better. And now they're dead. How do you feel about that, smart guy? We got 22 scrap, not quite enough to get the next level of weapon power. We're going to be leaving this floor without having gotten too much in the way of upgrades, but that's okay for now because we picked up that weapon. Ion bomb is good. There's our next bar of that, but we can't really afford... if we power down medbay and engines a little bit, we can get our hull laser up. We also have an ion bomb now. Does 4 ion damage. That's really nice, and it can stun potentially as well. What's its charge time relative to the Artemis? 22 seconds. Versus 11, but it does 4 damage and it goes around shield, so that might be a really valuable late game item for us. We can definitely jump at least one more, and burst laser combined with hull laser should basically just let us tear these units apart. So this guy is basically, it's a pirate shop. Maybe we're gonna attack him. Why do we attack him? We don't have scrap. How do we get scrap? Well, first off, we can't buy anything without scrap, which is the problem. Yeah, instead... Actually, you know what? We should fire on shields first, and then hull laser can take out the weapons with much lower chance. I guess it doesn't really matter in the whole scheme of things, does it? Our medbay has been stunned. That's pretty dangerous. Unfortunately, we're not really seeing the true power of the hull laser here because they have no systemless rooms, but we can really use it to tear through some enemies. Enemy ships, I should say, once we get a little further in. But for now, good job. We'll get 19 scrap for that. It's not a huge payday, but... it's better than not being able to buy something that they were selling. Important to pay attention to stuff like that, I think. Sure, we'll investigate the life forms on a nearby planet. We'll try to communicate peacefully, and that actually gave us an NG crew member. That's unexpected. So, NG crew member, I'm going to put you in Shield Town. We're going to get 2 more bars of reactor power so that we can get our dodge chance back up. And next thing is doors. Really like to have that by the end of the first sector, but we have a better weapon setup, so that's cool. But next thing is doors, followed by a second bar of shields, and we might even rush a third bar soon after that. But we could also go to the store, buy some good systems, buy some augments. Remember, primary objective is, of course, well, we have to fight them because we have no other choice. Or we could leave, but we need the scrap. Primary objective, of course, is just to win, but our secondary objective is... definitely to unlock the B layout of the Kestrel, which I think we should be able to accomplish. Oh, this is scary. Nope, not scary at all, actually. My mistake. Please. I wasted a little bit of our potential there, but that's okay. And now, I'm gonna go on their engines. They have a weapon, but it's not gonna do anything to me. And here comes the hull laser on their systemless room. This should be good. That could take them out. Oh, that's nice. Even makes a deeper sound, I think. I normally don't like hull weapons, but it's just nice to have 2 lasers to begin with. Sure, lots of stores in the vicinity. That doesn't really interest me that much. I have nothing to sell. I may actually end up selling the Artemis, but it doesn't sell for very much, so... that's not that big of a deal. It's very important to get the second bar of shields up, so enemies like this are not a problem anymore. Pike beam plus a single laser can do a ton of damage to us if, oh, good, good, good. Can do a ton of damage to us if we only have 1 bar of shields. If we have more bars of shields, can't do shit to us. You see, like, it just takes our shields down. No big deal. Here we go. On their engines, why their engines? So that we have a basically 100% dodge or 100% hit chance with our hull laser, which will then destroy them very, very quickly, twice as fast as we otherwise would. So we got swarm missiles and a lot of scrap. First things first, doors. Second thing, what the hell are swarm missiles? If given time to repair, the swarm launcher can replicate multiple warheads. So it's a charged missile launcher, like the ion we had last time. It shoots, I'm assuming, 3 missiles if you want it to. That seems like... That seems really interesting. It only requires 2 power, but the ion bomb only requires 1. You know, it's kind of like the Rebel flagship 3 missile launcher, but I think this is probably a little slower. That being said, that could be really useful. I think one thing's for sure, we're not going to need the Artemis. So we're going to sell the Artemis. What I'm worried about is having to be a little bit too aggressive. I would love to be able to buy some of these things, but we're not going to be able to. And that's expected. We knew that was going to happen. But anyway, we're going to sell Artemis. And we're going to put our swarm in here. We're probably not going to use the bombs or the swarm anytime soon, but it's nice to know we can just by micromanaging our weapon power a little bit, because we already have 5 bars. So we can basically run whatever we want to run. Now, what else do we want? We should go back to the store. Do we want another crew member? If it's an alien race, maybe. No, they're not. Steven Dengler is such a good crew member name. Emergency respirators take half damage from oxygen, stealth weapons. We can't buy any other weapons because we have nothing else to sell. I really think we just spend on fuel. Lifeform scanner. Detects the location of any lifeforms even when sensors don't function. I'm just gonna buy fuel. You know, let's not get too far away from the things that I know. I'm trying to play a little bit differently, but also I need to make sure that, you know, I'm still well within my wheelhouse. Of course, anytime it gives me the option to strip a ship, we're doing it. Just out for a strip, are ya, bud? This flat cannon scares the bejesus out of me. First things first, burst laser should land on the weapons. Please work. Please work. Please work. Here comes the dangerous part. Oh yeah, our shields are completely out. So in hindsight, I actually wish that I fired our second burst laser shot at their weapons. It's actually a hull laser. Oh, they must have had a fire? Because their weapons are in the red now, but they can still shoot. And they can still shoot. How does that happen? That's nuts, but anyway, our hull laser is going to completely take them out. No big deal. We took a little hull damage. It happens. We get a defense drone and some scrap. Pretty good. That means the next bar of shields is totally up, and I'm glad to have it. Now, we should probably pump a little bit into dodge chance. We should probably pump up our sensors, maybe? Okay, I guess we're just not welcome here. That's okay. We should still be able to make it to the exit. It's kind of I always get nervous or anxious, at least, when there's, like, not very many beacons in an area. Of course, we're gonna aid the civilian ship. They have a bomb and a laser, which could do some problem, or could mean some problems for us, but, sure, we're gonna fire in on their shields, and then their weapons. So, shields first, then weapons. Ooh, that didn't go so well, actually. But we did take their weapons completely offline, so it's just a matter of time now. I think I'm going to pump some points into dodge chance before shield, because that's kind of a slangy way of saying it, but 1/4 dodge chance is not very good. 25% dodge chance is not very good. So if we could just get that up to 30, 35, I'd feel pretty good about things. Got plenty of resources as a result of that. We can almost get that extra bar of reactor power. We literally need one more scrap. I imagine that'll probably happen on this beacon, or soon after, at the very least. Nope, nothing here. I am glad I bought more fuel. Not that it's dire yet, but it doesn't look like we're getting any anytime soon. You find a slug cruiser and a rock ship at a standoff. Hail them to see what's wrong. I always like to pay the rock debt off, and they usually upgrade one of our systems as a result, I think. Let's see. No, we didn't get anything. We just lost 10 scrap that time. Well, that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes in FTL. We're definitely going to have some combat here. It's just a missile launcher and a laser, which doesn't really bother me at all. Fire on... Why don't we just fire both on weapons? It seems pretty smart, actually. So I actually took oxygen away to give myself a better chance of dodging that missile. That's where my micro's at right now. Passable, maybe. We're gonna be fine here. No question about it. Their weapons are completely offline. Well, it looks like their laser might still be active, but let's be honest. The hull laser is gonna completely take them out. So, we'll just get our medbay powered up. Whoa, that didn't kill them. That's, unfortunate, but they're dead now. Wonderful. Extra 30 scrap means more reactor power. Now we can get our dodge chance back, and we're good to go. Now with a 30% chance to dodge, might even want to pump that up one more until we start reaching those diminishing returns. And everything looks good to me here. So far, so good. And once we start getting these missiles into the arrangement, that's going to be nice as well. I don't need to repair any hull damage right now. Let's go to the next sector, and I'm going to keep going to these red sectors because I want to get involved in as much combat as possible. game's easy on easy mode in the early section, so we might as well, it's only really the Rebel flagship that's a frustrating nightmare, but we might as well get as many combat opportunities as we can. These are all rock men, which is not really that scary, but kind of annoying, I guess. So they might be able to do some damage to our engines before the oxygen ends up becoming a problem. Mostly I'm concerned about this flat cannon combined with laser situation they've got going on here. And I'm just going to open these up just in case they decide or eventually manage to make it through here. And you know what? In fact, I could actually put you guys in here, and then we'll open these and this up. So even if they manage to get through that oxygen room, they're not going to be too happy about it. Okay, so here's the flat cannon. That's what scares me. And we will go on their weapons again with our other laser. They did do some damage, but it's just hull damage, so that's no big deal. Their surrender offer is not very good at all. Mind you, we're still pretty early in the game, so I didn't expect to oh, I should have locked them in. I can still get that guy. And sorry about that. Now that they're separated, it'll take them longer to get through the doors, so that's fine too. Good, good, good. Still haven't taken out their shields. I haven't even aimed at them, I guess. Why did I go on engines? Just so I'm less likely to miss, I suppose. And then burst laser will finish the job. No problems whatsoever. A little bit of hull damage, that's it. All right, everybody should wait for the oxygen to come back. We got 31 scrap, which is a little bit better than what we would have gotten from the surrender. So I'm going to send everybody back into their rooms, like so. And I'm going to take a sip of this coffee. And I learned my lesson. I just recorded the last episode. It took like 2 hours, and I'm like, I need some fucking caffeine if I'm going to make it through another 2 hour long episode. 1 second here. The burnt out hull of a rock mine lair drifts by. Behind the wreck drifts a live mine, an automated drone that drills into ship's hulls before exploding. It locks onto your ship's signature and heads your way. Attempt evasive maneuvers. The ship's turning circle proves too wide and the mine bites down onto the hull. You can hear it now chewing through the armor. Attempt a controlled detonation using a missile. Okay, we got 4 damage to our hull, but we also got 21 scrap. Was it worth it? Almost certainly not, but it's nice to have, I guess. And as we're repairing here, we'll just pick up one more bar of dodge chance. That's a new encounter that I've never seen before, actually. So now when the pilot system is repaired, which will hopefully happen soon, we will have a 35% dodge chance, which will improve as our engineer, they're not really an engineer, but the person who mans the engines becomes a little bit stronger. System repair drone is fine. We'll probably end up selling that just because I have no appreciation for drones, even though they did help out on the last episode. Not a ton, but enough. Enough for me to respect them, at least. Why do we fire on weapons first? We fire on weapons first because, if possible, I would love to stop them from being able to shoot at us at all. And if we can, you know, wait, why is oxygen going down? I thought I saw oxygen just go down a little bit. Yeah, if we're able to shoot on their weapons once, then we shouldn't get hit again. Now, it's just par for the course, as the Kestrel at least, to expect to expect to take hull damage. The reason we didn't take hull damage basically at all in the last run until the very end is because we had that energy shield to protect us, which basically takes 5 shots on the chin, which is also a great name for a porno, totally by accident, but geez, right? It's just gonna happen. I'm okay with giving them 4 fuel. They upgraded our reactor by 1, which is nice. That's pretty good. We can't get that next bar of shields yet, so I don't think we're gonna do anything. Maybe we'll get 1 more bar of engine power. No, we can't, actually. And this is where we hit diminishing returns, so actually, maybe we're okay with 35 dodge chance. Especially if we can get cloaking in the future. This is an okay jump here. Not enough scrap to really buy anything from the shops. I think shops are gonna become more valuable to us as we get later into the game. Mostly because we'll get more scrap. So, they've boarded us. That was a silly decision. I wouldn't recommend doing that if you're a prospective interstellar terrorist out there. You're just going to hide out in this room, and this is going to be bad for them. Burst laser on weapons, because I really don't want to get hit by laser plus beam. I don't even know if they can do damage to me just looking at their capabilities right now. They've already taken like 1 hit to their oxygen room just as a result of the asteroids. All of their weapons are also now offline. You know what, why don't you just get in the med bay for now? All of their weapons are now offline, so really, they're basically done. They can't really, or we can't really, or they can't really do anything, sorry, that's what I meant to say. Yeah, hull laser will take them out, and actually an asteroid did it first. So what do we do here? We basically just wait. Unfortunately, this is one of the silliest elements of FTL. why would we kill this dude? Just shoot him with a taser or something and let him become our next... Or we just offer him an ultimatum and be like, hey, do you want to, like, man our drone room? Or, sorry, our door room? And he'll be like, yeah, because it beats dying. And we'll be like, cool, dude. That's awesome. I'm glad that you have a good head on your shoulders. I think we need 100 to be able to upgrade our next level of shields. Now, everyone's basically fine, so let's get them back to their rooms. And we'll jump out here a little bit further. Good sector for grinding some scraps so far. If we can get the third bar of shields, I'd feel really nice. But keep in mind that, you know, the most important thing with this ship is to get some missile defense. Whether through evasion, which is maybe the least ideal way to do it, because it's not guaranteed, unless you have cloaking, in which case it's really good. So whether through evasion or cloaking, or a combination thereof, or a drone that would help me out. Those are high on my list of things to do, no question about it. So we're going to go on shields with our hull laser, just because if I could take them out, that makes my life easier. Also, you know, with the whole asteroid situation that they have going on, it's going to be really hard for them to do anything here. Mostly, though, the hull laser should just completely destroy them here by shooting on a systemless room. I like that the hull laser gives you the flexibility. You know what? That's an okay surrender because I really need fuel. And more missiles is good because we're going to be using them eventually. And hopefully we enter a safe beacon soon so I can actually upgrade my ship because we have a lot of scrap. But if there's a store, that would be cool too. All right, here's what we're going to do here. I'm going to test out a new way to deal with fires. And solar flares frequently cause fires. So I think we should like basically get all the oxygen sucked out of basically every room that we don't want to hide in. Why? Because this will then allow me to put out the fires faster. You should not be in the engine room. This will then allow me to put out the fires faster if they come on board. It's a little bit risky. It might even be a little bit stupid. But that's maybe what I like the most about it, to be honest with you. So, I mean, good luck, fire. There's only like two rooms on the ship that could even sustain you right now. There we go. Weapons are more or less offline. Hull laser has completely taken out their shields. Now we'll probably go oxygen. And, it doesn't really matter. Let's go engine, or pilot, and, then empty room. So, hull laser's gonna kill them. No question about it. We might be able to jump before the fire starts? Oh, wow, hull laser didn't kill them. Okay, so the fire, unfortunately, did end up on one of the two rooms that actually causes a problem for us. And it causes a large problem because, first off, let's close doors. It causes a large problem because we need to repair this in order to be able to jump away. Luckily, we have an NG. It's getting repaired quickly. All right, that could have gone worse, let's be honest. And we're still going to be able to get out of this sector without running into serious trouble, but we've just been in danger constantly. All right, everyone get back to your room of choice. So, oh, the NG never got saved into the shield room, so we'll rectify that as well. They've boarded us again? Well, you know, the oxygen's already pretty low, so here you go. Good luck to you. He's going to start to take damage basically right away. We're going to go on the weapons as always. Not even as usual. And as they land, we'll then go on... Yeah, we'll go on shields just to keep them down. That way the burst laser can do more damage next time. And that can end up hitting like their piloting system or something. Subsystem, I guess, to be 100% accurate. And then the hull laser, we're just going to, you know, exercise our flexibility here. And make sure that we take them out as quickly as possible. Works totally fine. And there they go. Not even a chance for surrender, which is good, because I probably wouldn't take it anyway. So we're up to like 200 scrap. Why am I not spending it? Because if we get something incredible in a store, weapon pre-igniter, for example, that's what I want to go for. And that's expensive. We are going to explore the asteroid field. We got nothing. Next store, by the way, we need to buy fuel as well. We're going to go to the civilian sector. There's a lot of red beacons after it, or red areas after it, which I like. I like a lot. Okay, so there's not a store, but there is a distress beacon. Hull integrity is getting to the point where I'm a little nervous now. We're going to give them the fuel. And in return, they gave us the ion blast, which I'm familiar with. Very, very familiar with from using that Zoltan ship so much. I can't resist, basically. I'm going to fight these mercenaries here. They have a flat cannon. That scares me a lot. But we should be okay anyway. Why are you in the... You should be in here, and then we'll save it. Okay. We might get lucky with our first shots here, but I think really both of our shots should just go in on the weapons right away. Oh man, this is not good, actually. We took out one thing. They still have the flat cannon. But we've got an Amari song brewing here, so try this again. You can do it. Oh, that's good. Okay. Wow, that was their flat cannon. Just annoying, really. Now, what we should do, honestly, is just wait. They've only got a laser active right now, so let's take a second to be patient while they're fixing things. And we're going to fire burst and hull laser at the same time. So we're going to send you back, even though we can see what's going on now. We're going to fire burst and hull laser at the same time, so we have a much greater chance to actually keep their weapons offline. There we go. That's pretty good. A bunch of people just leveled up as well. Yeah, now we'll probably go on shields with both of our weapons. Wow. That was bad timing on my part. Very, very bad timing on my part. Just wait a second. Be patient. They're not shooting anything at us, so we have all the time in the world to plan accordingly. I imagine we didn't kill that mantis, so there might be repairs, but if we did kill the mantis, that's really bad for them. All right, we at least took one bar of shields out. Now we can pretty much stop the charade. There are going to be times when it is best to do this, to take out one enemy. What was I even saying there? Not to take out one enemy at a time, but to fire both of our weapons at the same time, just so we have the maximum value of lasers coming out. We have to accept this because of the fuel situation, basically. And I'm not upgrading anything because I need to go to the shop. Tomo, it's okay, my man. Don't worry about it. Okay. This is a dangerous ship. That's a lot of lasers and, more importantly, a missile. What do we do? Actually, because of the missile, I just want to handle this room very, very simply and not worry about oxygen until we have a fire. The reason being, I don't want to accidentally, like, take all the oxygen out of a room and then, all of a sudden find it impossible for me to do anything. Yeah, they're going to surrender. We're going to take it again. We can afford to take that. And we may be able to jump. Yeah, we can. And there's a store. Okay, so fuel, healing, augments. We'll see. They have two pages. That's what I wanted to see. So let's take a look at this. I don't really like their selection of augments. I really like mind control and hacking. Why is it good to buy mind control and hacking? So many reasons, but also it helps us get closer to getting that second level. Do they have a drone control unit? No, okay. It helps us get close to that second layout of the ship. So we're going to sell system repair drone. We're going to sell ion blaster. It pains me to do so because I really like that weapon. But we're going to sell the defense drone because if we buy a drone control unit, we get one anyway. Wouldn't be the worst thing in the world to have two. But now the real question is, do we want a halberd beam? It goes through one level of shields, I think, which is really nice. But first, mind control and hacking. We're going to buy them both. And then I want to take a look at our ship for a second here. Are there crew to buy? No. Okay, well, fuel. We got to buy all that. We should heal up to green at least. Now we have 113. And we do need some reactor power. At least one. So let's just pick up one for now. And then let's look at this. What would we need to use the halberd beam? It takes 3 power, so we would actually need... Well, what we could do is just take out their shields with our lasers and then power on the halberd beam. So if we actually, like, took out their shields and then turned hull laser off and turned halberd beam on, then that would be incredible. But the hull laser kind of accomplishes the same thing as the halberd beam. What's the charge time on the halberd beam? That's not the right one. Halberd beam, charge time 17 seconds. I believe that the burst laser is, the hull laser is 15 seconds. I think we should buy it. I think we should buy it and mess around a little bit here. So we're gonna buy the halberd beam. And this is gonna stay in our cargo for now. May we eventually use ion bombs, swarm, etc., etc.? Yeah, but for now, I really like this kind of combination that we've got going on. Might as well keep like ion bomb on here just in case, but I really like this combination. Why? Take out their shields. Immediately when their shields go out, turn off hull laser, turn on halberd beam. Halberd beam can go through one bar of shields even, and it's nice. It's quite nice. Now, what do we need to power it up here? Hull laser for now. In fact, burst laser plus halberd beam is probably a better combination to start with, but we'll check that out and see if it actually ends up being indeed correct. But for now, we have one more bar of power that goes on to hacking. It does use a drone part, so we're not going to use it too much yet. But we will use mind control, basically religiously. Now, we have to go to the nebula anyway. We might as well go here first. We spent a lot of scrap. Did we spend it in the right place? Remains to be seen, doesn't it? So, why can we see? We can see because we have this guy in the sensor room. So, actually, I do want to upgrade sensors now that we have mind control. But first things first, mind control. Mind control on weapons. Why not? Just to mess with him. And why can't we see anymore? Oh, because we took the guy out. All right, that makes a lot of sense. So, we won't fire the halberd beam right away. Oh, sorry, we won't fire the burst laser right away. What we will do is wait for the halberd beam to be charged. Why? Because then we can do this. We fire in on the weapons, and as soon as one bar, or as soon as both bars go down, ideally, then the halberd beam just goes here, and it does a lot of damage, but it's a very short beam. But that's okay. Look at all of the rooms that it's hitting here. That might kill them. It did a lot. We're not going to accept surrender here, because there's no reason to accept surrender here. Look at all the damage that we did to them right away. We've even got them mind controlled. Like, this is over. And I am tempted to upgrade our weapon systems because it would be nice to get hull laser working at exactly the same time. It would make us a serious offensive powerhouse. But anyway, second level of sensors go up. What's next? Next level of shields. And get mind control and hacking buffed up, I guess. But more weapon power isn't the worst thing in the world. But keep in mind, we need 3 weapon power to use all these weapons that I have at the same time. And 3 weapon power is not too bloody cheap. That's going to be like 250 for us. I should have checked it, but that's okay. Once you arrive, your screen lights up with warnings. A nearby pirate seems to have advanced hacking tools. They've tried to shut down your engines. Your crew manages to keep them barely operational, and you move into attack. Sure, let's counter the remote hacking. Doesn't even cost us a drone part. Doesn't mean it means we can't hack for this, but I think it means they can't hack either. So we will mind control their pilot, drastically lower their dodge chance, I think. And we can basically just use burst laser right away because halberd beam will go through their weapon anyway, and burst laser has a chance to take out their missile before it can shoot. And it did. Wonderful. Okay, halberd beam is very small, but engines, weapons, oxygen, that's going to hurt them a great deal. It does go through one bar of shields. Excellent. Okay, let's just stay. The mind control unit actually killed the other one. That's nice. And, sure, halberd beam. Might as well just run it along this way. It's not like they're going to live through it regardless. And maybe it would be nice to get one more bar of weapon power just to get an ion bomb working. We got 4 fuel and 57 scrap. That's actually really nice. So weapons is going to it's going to cost us 265 if we want to get all weapons firing at once. But imagine how useful that would be. For now, though, we'll talk about it. But I do think that mind control is nice. We can get another level of that easily and then get the reactor power. And next thing is shields. We get that third bar of shields next. We can hit this distress beacon. It'll cost us some fuel. But I think it's worth it to give us what I assume is going to be a higher degree of scrap or a cool encounter. Yeah, sure, beam weapon, carefully cut them out. We got 39 scrap and a fuel for it, so it only cost us 1 fuel, and we got enough back in return, I would say. Power up mind control a little bit more. Mind control gets really, really buffed as you use it more and more. So yeah, next will be third bar of shields. But for now, pretty good for a Kestrel run is my impression of how this is going so far. Keep in mind, we scaled nicely because we have these bombs that we haven't even touched yet as well. So, you know what, we should probably, we should have depowered the hull laser, because I think the hull laser could actually do more damage, or at the very least do the same amount of damage, but faster. They didn't breach, so that's no big deal. Halberd beam's going to be good to go in a second. I don't think it'll kill them, but it's going to do a number on. There we go, 4 rooms, and it actually did kill them. Pretty good. So that gives us 40 scrap. It's actually really nice. Please tell me we can get away. Perfect. Into the exit at the nebula scares me a little bit. But we could get lucky. Nothing. Okay. So, why don't we upgrade our shields? That's going to cost us 100. And then we'll take power away from our engines just for now. I know that people get frustrated with it because it lowers evade chance, but that's fine. Mantis homeworlds or Mantis controlled? Mantis homeworlds, man. Go big or go home. Good so far. Again, a lot of our damage as the Kestrel is more or less unavoidable. Next thing I should really get after reactor power is maybe a drone control unit. Just a defense drone would really help out a lot. Let's dock and try to rescue the survivors of this scientific fire event. Usually causes hull damage. This time it actually gave us a crew member. I wouldn't hold out a lot of hope for getting... I guess you're going to be our... Can we have you in the hacking room? Like, do you actually get value out of being there? Otherwise, we'll send you into the sensor Yeah, you don't get any value. Send you into the sensor room or the door room. Ah, we can vary it as necessary. There we go. Sure, we'll save for now. But yeah, a drone control unit would be awesome. I wouldn't hold out a lot of hope for me getting six aliens on the ship. We only have one right now. We're six different types of species, basically. We only have one right now, which is not very good for us. Or two, sorry, which is still not very good for us. So we could use some drone parts to hack them here. I don't think it's worth it. Instead, we'll just make this NG, like, super weak. Or the super weak NG, I should say. We'll give him a some mind control, and maybe he'll help us destroy their weapons. So because they have two bars of shields, we're not going to shoot burst laser right away. This is the scary part. All right, medbay's hurt. We'll send our NG in there to fix it. Now, halberd beam's almost up. Give it a second. Now, burst laser will send in on the weapons just in case it hits, which it probably won't, but... Oh, it did. Okay, and then halberd beam like so is going to ruin their existence. That's going to be 8 damage, theoretically, plus those are important systems getting hurt. We ended up not being able to hit the weapons in time, I think, which is kind of unfortunate, but they've got enough problems that I feel like we're totally good here. I think our weapon crew got a level up there. And we got a defense drone Mark II. That's what we need if we get a drone control unit. That will block way more missiles coming in. We've got some fuel in a drone part, more fuel, more missiles, and more scrap. That actually feels really good. Drone control units seem to be pretty easy to come by. I think we've got a good chance here. Is there a store? There's not a store. What that means is that I will put our reactor power back up, and we should be able to get to 85 scrap to buy another drone, or to buy a drone control system if we find one. And I expect we will. Usually we do. Alright, so they're gonna. It's basically just six of one, half a dozen of the other here. We could hack their weapon systems. I really don't want to use a drone part if I don't have to. And again, with two bars of shields, we are gonna focus on using burst laser at the same time as the halberd beam. Ooh, maybe should have hacked here, but I really don't want to use drone parts until it's absolutely vital. Here we go. They fired their missiles. Did we really miss on, like, all those shots? I'm still going to use halberd beam just to get their weapons out, because I really don't want to get hit by this missile launcher. Please work. We hurt them. We hurt them enough. All right, NG, you're our repairman. Get over here to this breach. Missile launcher's not active anymore, which makes me much more comfortable with this whole situation. Mind control unit is, oh, that was stupid of me. I should have waited, but I think we're going to be fine. Their laser can't do anything, remember, so just wait for the burst laser to be back up, and there it is. See if we hit. Pretty good, and then give him another one of these bad boys right here. This is really going to hurt that dude who's in this room as well. Real sorry about that. It's probably going to... I thought it might take out their engines. They want to surrender. I'm going to accept it. And the reason I accepted it is because I think they, because the halberd beam takes a while to charge, I think they may have stood a reasonably good chance, maybe like a 40% chance to get away. So why not just take the 100% chance at what's probably like 80% of what we'd actually get anyway. Okay, I'm going to send crew to help because we have extra crew, but normally I wouldn't. Hey, okay, we actually got a hull smasher laser, lots of missiles, which is nice, and a drone part and plenty of scrap. There's a store. Can we make it back? Absolutely. So... drone control unit, or weapon pre-igniter, or, well, we'll see. Ion stunner. This is pretty bad. Well, we'll fix it up. We'll buy as much fuel as we can. Ion stunner takes 1 power. Takes 10 seconds to shoot. It would take out 1 bar of shields is the thing. And it stuns crew inside the room, and it does ion damage. So I almost want to buy it just so that we can take out... for all these ships that have 2 bars of shields, we take out 1 bar of shields in 10 seconds. Then burst laser does its thing, and halberd beam, worst case scenario, can still do damage. So I think that's worth buying. I don't think anything else here is worth buying. I think at this point, we sell... oh, we gotta sell something, don't we? Hull laser we don't need. We've already got one. It's good. I think it's a really, really good idea to keep the swarm missiles. Because this could, firing 3 missiles could really devastate some enemy shields. I think we can sell the ion bomb, honestly, and keep the ion stunner instead. And if we need to, as the game gets a little bit further along, we'll swap out this ion stunner for the swarm, and that'll be nice. It's good to be spoiled for choice. I'm not using swarm yet, but look at this, 50 missiles. That's what I'm hoping to get to. That way, firing 3 missiles doesn't feel like I'm you know, like I should be scared about the amount that I'm spending. Now, you know, I don't think it's the stupidest idea in the world to get mind control maxed out right away. We'll still have 37 scrap left over. And what comes next? Maybe we try to get to fourth bar of shields, but I am, like, the drone control unit is so important for us. Now, we have an automated enemy ship. Oh, those beam drones are going to be really frustrating to deal with because they also have, well, we also have an asteroid field here. So I can't mind control them because there's nobody to mind control. I actually am going to use a, I'm going to use a drone part, and I'm going to fire on the drone control unit. I don't know if that's the right place to fire on, but at the very least, we can stop them from taking our shields. We're taking out something, at least. We can't stop the asteroids. We can stop weapons or drones. There's two drones. They're going to fire pretty quickly. I think we go on the drone control unit. Look at them. They're going to explode, I think, actually. We'll see. Ion Stunner's not powered up. Am I an idiot? Oh, I can't power it up, actually. We need one more bar of weapon power quickly. That's fine. We should be able to get through this fight without it for now. And we can hack in a little while. We will want to upgrade that before things get too far along. And this is the moment of truth. All right, fire on weapons. Good hits. And then let's go on drone control weapons, and we probably won't be able to hit the piloting system. Oh, we can. Okay, that's nice. All right, that is much, much better. So we are not going to take any damage here in all likelihood. We can hack them again in a second. We might as well. We already spent on it, so see if the lasers can actually do their job. Yeah, more or less. I'm happy with it. And with only one bar of shields up, then the halberd beam should finish the job. Good damage potential. 43 extra scrap is nice. Nothing else of value here. We'll be on the lookout for another store as we move along. Can't stress enough how much I would love to get that drone control unit up, because seriously, having a little bit more missile defense is actually... Oh, can we make it from there? We gotta get to this one. So I was thinking we'd go like, but we can't. So we might as well make a beeline for this exit, actually. Otherwise, we would probably get caught by the rebels, which is fine. Intruders on board. Ah, my favorite. Intruders on board. Oh, how I abhor. Anyway... I hope you're not getting tired of my singing voice. You should get tired of my singing voice, but I hope you're not tired of it. Oh, he fixed a breach and then I just never brought him back. Great skills. Okay, so whatever, you know, take out whatever you want to take out as long as it's not the oxygen. Doesn't really bother me at all. Oh, I should have closed him in. That was stupid of me. If we got nobody in our shield room, whatever. We'll let them take their sweet ass time here. Why don't you get into the med bay as well? Yeah, take a walk, distract them for a second, that's good. Oh, so they're gonna try. You know what, we might as well, like, close this stuff off. Just so that we can hopefully get our, hacking system back and save ourselves a little time. And we'll power up our medbay because we can, and we can fight in the medbay. Because they're already significantly wounded. Yeah, okay, let's close all doors. And then send NG back in here. And the medbay is powered up, so we're going to be fine. It's just annoying that we don't get any scrap for it, but apart from that, that's okay. So, everybody, back to your rooms. Theoretically, could/should heal everybody, but that's okay. Not the end of the world right now. We could upgrade our ship, but I don't want to, because I would rather... Yeah, we can still do this. I would rather, again, save for that possibility of a drone control unit, because if I don't get it, and like I find it, but I can't... pick it up quickly enough, then that sucks. Okay, so we've got another, thankfully, another boarding here. And this time it's got the added risk, or should I say excitement, of possibly being able to start like a whole bunch of fires. So that's nice. Always like when that happens. And what are we doing here? We're basically just getting all of the oxygen deprived right now. I didn't mean to open that door. I'm very stupid sometimes. But in doing this, we've at least separated the crew from one another, so they're not going to get any benefits from cooperation. But yeah, you know, there could be solar flares here too, which is awesome as well. Really psyched about that, the possibility that there could be fires in addition to having to fight these guys. Let's close all doors. Gotta go. Gotta go. Gotta go. You lived. Thank you for doing that. Hopefully, we just don't have intruders here, or, you know, people that board us. If I fight, that's fine. I can get through with fighting. But you know what? I'm just going to take the scrap for now. We are going to send people into the medbay now. Jones in particular. Please God, get yourself fixed up. You're a goddamn train wreck. How about you? You're all right. NG could use a little healing. Everyone else is okay. Sure. Could be worse. I just really hate micromanaging the health of our crew members. It's not the end of the world. Send you over here. How's our power looking? Yeah, we don't need power in the med bay, so it's looking fine. What did we need again? I'm gonna jump to this exit, and then we're gonna... I think I need one bar of weapon power so I can have the ion stunner active. But we've had so much danger lately that it was just something to worry about. Inquire about their specialty. They offer to upgrade your doors in exchange for 25 scrap. Sure, you know, it's cheaper than we would pay. So now we don't have to keep a crew member in the door room. Not that we were doing it to begin with, but you get the idea. So we've upgraded weapon power. Is this the way we want our weapons to look in the end game? Probably not, but it is the way they're going to look for now. Yeah, next sector, Rebel Stronghold or Abandoned Sector. Let's go Rebel Stronghold. I feel lucky right now.